I'm sure I'm not the first person to talk about this, but why is it a millionaire baseball player can bat 300 and he would be up for the batting title? Or a Cy Young pitcher can have 30 starts, win 20, and get the award? Or even an NFL quarterback can throw for 20 touchdowns and 10 interceptions? The reason? They're better than their peers. So, how can you be a successful technician? Let's chat. Welcome back. I'm Chris Morin with HVAC Pro Blog, and this week I'm going to talk about how to be a successful technician in the HVAC industry. Imagine if you were out there trying to get the diagnosis right and it was done correctly two-thirds of the time, like a baseball player. For one, I doubt the employer would even keep you on the payroll, but also the homeowner wouldn't even have you back. So, what makes a good technician? Not the guy winning the Cy Young getting it right two-thirds of the time. No matter how far along in the industry you are, here's a short list of what I think makes a great tech. First off, you need to have a clear understanding of the basics. This is something you learn right in vocational school. If I need to explain how to measure amps or what a multimeter is, we have a problem. I'm gonna tell you, this assures no batting title and no chance I want you on my team. Also, it's not just enough to know how to take the measurement. I want technicians to know what the measurements mean. This feeds into proper diagnosis the first time. Also, if you're working on HVAC equipment, you really need to have a Physics 101 course under your belt. I hated this class in high school, but I am so glad I took it and aced it with a lot of hard work. Basic physics has helped me in every job I've ever had since day one in HVAC. All right, next up sounds very basic, but I wanna make sure technicians know when their licenses or certifications expire. Knowing these dates shows they have some pride for their accomplishments and contribution to the industry. If they know the expiration, they most likely know the requirements to renew. I'm gonna be honest here, your employer or manager should not have to keep track of this for you. I'm sure they already have kids at home they need to worry about. Next item, punctuality and initiative. I say these two in one. It's not enough just to be on time and properly dressed. You also need to know what you should be doing that day. If you were a service manager, like I was quite some time ago, wouldn't it be nice to have all of your tickets turned in on time with payment, trucks cleaned, all the inventory put back on the truck, and tickets ready to go in the morning for that day? Technician just picks them up and goes. They knew what they were doing that day. So it's not just the technician's responsibility, it's also the manager's responsibility to make sure that punctuality and initiative is part of the equation. Now, as a technician, there's a lot that you can do to make this happen without the manager forcing it down your throat. But if you're the service manager, start to listen to your technicians and consider their feedback. This is definitely a way to identify the key players in your organization and to see who has that initiative and what you can plan for in the future. All right, number four, knowledge is power. There is nothing more powerful in this world than your knowledge. I learned this a week two at boot camp in 3rd Battalion on Paris Island. Ideally, we'd like to learn from those who already learned the hard way. We don't want to make those same mistakes. Some 5 years later, I also had a saying in my platoon, we needed to work smarter, not harder. I'm sure it's not the first time you heard that, but I bet you haven't lived by it. So how do we apply that? Imagine you're out there working on a piece of equipment and you've been there for, let's say, over an hour, and you're not sure what the diagnosis is. This means you need to stop and call somebody that has the knowledge. This could be the local distribution, the tech support for the manufacturer, or even just a colleague in the industry. Trust me, I still get these calls from my friends, I don't wanna say daily, but more than once a week. But finding something new, even decades into the industry, is what keeps our technicians engaged and wanting to learn. This is exactly how I figured out the hard way that I need to keep up with the changes in the HVAC industry. When you settle on the fact that you don't know everything, those classes that are available at distribution in the evenings or early mornings, or taking the e-learnings that are available now, you find that there's more in it for you than the company that you work for. You see, if you have to leave that company for whatever reason, you may have to turn in tools or specific pieces that they bought you, but you don't turn in your knowledge. That goes with you throughout your entire career. Also, believe it or not, there's still new equipment coming out every day in our industry. It's centered around efficiency and comfort. This means training is really important, and a lot of old timers that are aging out of our industry are more worried about quitting time each day than they are learning about the new things being released. There are a lot of things that you can learn from these guys and gals, but don't fall into this trap. Just because they're content with their spot in the industry and aging out and not being a great mentor does not mean you should follow in those footsteps. Our industry is already in dire need of engaged, qualified technicians. Ones that can fill unrealistic expectations by homeowners and employers alike. And I'm gonna be honest, you're gonna make much less than 10% of what the worst Major League Baseball player makes. But you better get the diagnosis right 99% of the time. Thanks for joining me at HVAC ProBlog, where we provide advice for residential system design, quality installation, and system diagnosis. See you next week.